life of President Mandela. In this latter part of his life, he had the fame, he had the money, he had the material things. Look at what he did, choosing to work with children, choosing to build schools all over the country. All this materialistic thing that we see people, you know, showing around their wealth and all that, you know, in an extravagant way, President Mandela did nothing of the kind. So let's think about that. Think about, again, when he left office, what we had about him. He was never, you know, accused at any stage of undermining the constitution of our country, using his position to enrich himself. When there were issues where there were allegations that he may have not complied strictly with the constitution, he was prepared to go to court. He was one of the first president that went to court, and he was prepared to say, I will take whatever the court decides. So I told the Vice Chancellor in saying, the legacy of Mandela is a great legacy, and God has been kind to him, and he has been extremely kind and generous to us. Let's take the right lessons and dedicate ourselves to reflecting deeply where we are, what things we can do differently to carry on that great legacy. While I was here, it has got great expectations on us. It is saying South Africans are the people who produced Mandela. They have high expectations. The challenges of poverty, unemployment, the health problems that we face as a country are all challenges. But having seen what Mandela was able to achieve, even under greater challenges, these challenges that we face, we're capable of overcoming them. We just have to reflect deeply and take the right decision and have the discipline and the integrity to see our plans being carried out. I sincerely hope you have taken to heart the challenge